Okay, great 11s.
I'm sorry, but I forgot my coffee. I have a video to play for you guys. It's on the War of 1812. You're going to be tested on this, so please pay close attention.
In 1812, the young nation
of
the United States.
Okay, 11s, I'll be right back.
Powerful navy in the world, in a war that would affect more than just the former colonies and their colonizer. The United States of America first gained freedom from the British in an 8-year-long revolutionary war that finally came to a close when Britain inevitably.
Yo, Aiden, go, he won all this. You're right, I'll go.
On September 3rd, 1783. One of the most relevant impacts of
Aiden,
this war,
I really don't think that's a good idea. He said he'd be back soon.
US and Britain once again. He'll take long enough.
Time to learn about real history. Where should we start?
What about the swinging 60s?
I say we go back to Mr. Shooter's video. We have a test in 2 days.
60s it is!
We interrupt this program for a very special report from the SCG News. America, lands of freedom, has just managed to land the first man on the moon after years of research. For more details, I'm going to now pass it to our STG reporters, Nicholas D'Elia and Jimmy Lazang.
Good morning, everybody. Today, the most historic call has just come from the White House. President Nixon himself has confirmed that we have landed the first man on the moon ever. Now, we've been working very hard for years upon years now to make this happen. And after multiple failed attempts, we have successfully, thanks to NASA, landed on the moon. What do you think of that, Jimmy?
Yeah. It's truly amazing. The astronaut Jack Lugar stepped out on the alien surface at 8:17 this evening, 400,000 kilometers away from home.
Wow, what a shocking advancement in technology. It's amazing to show the world what we as a species can do when we put our minds together, along with a little bit of hard work. Jimmy?
Yeah, turns out anything is possible. Who have known? What a marvel to human nature.
Thank you for listening to the SCG News. Now, a return to your program.
Okay, you saw your swinging 60s. Now let's get back to Mr. Streeter's video. Please, we have a test.
Well, that was anticlimactic. I wanted the swinging 60s, not the moon landing.
I don't know. I thought that was pretty cool.
Let's keep going. What's next?
Guys, no.
Another one? Maybe from like the 60s or the 90s? Come on, guys. Thoughts?
Guys, let's just go in order. Let's go to the 70s and then work our way up.
A 70s game show, what do you think?
Is there anything I can say to make you guys take this seriously?
Sounds great. Let's play it.
It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Rosa family. Ava, Hila, Chelsea, and Helena. Ready for action. And the Lemkovitz family. Joey, Jackie, Max, and Jordana, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. And for the star of our show, Desmond.
And welcome to Family Feud. We see you once a week, but tonight, we have two beautiful families. They come to fight it out, to honor their love for one another, and to win $10,000! And our first family of the night, the Rosas! Hey, and how are you doing tonight? Well, Ava, how about you introduce your family to the world?
This is my sister, Hila. Hi, I'm Hila. Thank you for having me on Family Feud. The Rosas are gonna win tonight.
Whoa!
This is my wonderful baby daughter, Chelsea.
Nice to meet you too, Chelsea.
And lastly is my grandmother, Helena.
Hello? Where am I? Help!
And that is some family. Let's hear it for the Rosas! And now, let's hear it for the Lemkovitzes! So, Jackie, is there anything you'd like to say to the world that's watching you right now?
Oh my God, I am so happy to be here right now. I'm in love with the feud, and of course you, Desmond.
How about you just introduce your family, Jackie?
Actually, I'm not in any way, shape, or form related to any of these people. I just wanted to play the feud, and I've never seen any of these people in my life before. Except for Joey. I see him in the Starbucks line every morning.
Hello there.
Okay, that's enough. Let's get into the games. Jackie! Ava! Get ready. You guys are up first.
Okay, that's enough. Don't you guys care about your futures?
Yeah, but maybe I want to be a historian, all right? Plus, I also really, really wanted to see who won the family feud. Guys, let's keep watching. What's next?
The 80s are next. I'm thinking maybe a classic movie?
Ooh! I'll put on The Breakfast Club. I've always wanted to see what our parents' lives were like when they were our age.
Well, well, look what we have here. You have exactly 7 hours and 56 minutes to sit here and think about what you've done.
Excuse me, but I don't think I deserve to be here on a Saturday.
You will not talk. You will not move from these seats. Understood?
So hard?
Well, I actually find that studying helps me perform better on my tests.
Perform better on my tests? Come on, man. Why don't you just leave him alone?
Fine. Leave him alone.
So, are you two, like, dating? Prom, king and queen, Romeo and Juliet?
Knock it off!
Shut up!
What does it matter anyways? You're both popular.
Why do you care? It's not like you make a difference at this school.
Oh yeah? Well, maybe I should go join the football team. Or the debate club.
No, they wouldn't take you.
Oh, I'm hurt.
I'm in the math club.
What's going on in here? I thought I told you to stay quiet.
I hate detention.
At least it's better than being stuck in a classroom.
Mr. Schroeder is really taking a while, isn't he?
Well, I'd say he's taking an appropriate amount of time. Besides, he always encourages us to educate ourselves. That's exactly what we're doing. Well, the 90s are next. What does everyone else think?
Sports grew a lot in the 90s. How about that?
I like a lot of the celebrities from the 90s. How about a Met Gala?
Welcome to the 1996 Met Gala. We're here with our gorgeous fashionistas showing off their best looks. Our theme for the night is red carpet pop culture. My name is Elle. This is Dylan. Welcome.
Hello, everyone. And here comes our first guest of the night. Leading the group is Madonna.
Oh, wow.
Madonna, come here, this way. You look absolutely stunning in that outfit tonight.
Yes, tell us, what are you wearing?
Thank you both. It's a Donna Gold and Deep Rose collection. I think it's quite Vogue, don't you?
Yeah, I think it looks edgy.
Madonna, you've become such an icon to so many people. We were wondering, what would you say to anyone watching?
I would say, don't be afraid to express yourselves. And thank your lucky stars that you were all born as unique as you are.
Very inspiring. Thank you for your time, Madonna.
Down the line, you might have seen him in the wrestling world or his acting career, The Rock.
Dwayne, we're such huge fans.
Pleasure, pleasure.
We've seen you venture into the WWE, pull off some pretty crazy stunts. That has me wondering, where does the name The Rock come from? I mean, those are some pretty rock-hard muscles.
Let's move on, next question.
Anyway, what's one word of advice for your fans?
It's about drive, power. Stay hungry out there.
Ooh, and here's Hollywood's fan favorite couple, Brad Pitt and Jennifer Aniston.
So, how's it going, you two?
We like to keep things low-key. Everyone wants to know everything about us right now.
Hmm. Very mysterious and interesting. Well, have a good one. Oh, and here comes Angelina Jolie.
So, Angelina, let's get straight to the point. There's been rumors surfacing that Brad Pitt's been cheating on his long-term girlfriend, Jennifer Aniston, with none other than you.
Let's just say what happens in show business stays in show business.
Well, that was certainly unexpected, but here comes a flood of new stars coming down the red carpet.
Wow, look at Leonardo DiCaprio. He's wearing a gorgeous suit made by Dreger Design Co., as well as a button down from Gannon Grinnell's Co. What a heartthrob.
Ooh, and look at this. Someone I'd never thought I'd see at a Met Gala, Johnny Depp, wearing an interesting jacket made by O'Connor's Chill Fits.
Johnny, I love your movies.
What do you want?
We just want to ask some questions, if that's okay.
Ugh.
Finally, we have the star of his upcoming blockbuster, Austin Powers, Mike Myers, wearing a gorgeous suit made by Vieira and Vuitton's line, along with some kicks from Schuber Shoes.
Well, that wraps it up, folks. Thanks for attending the 1996 Met Gala.
Hope you enjoyed it. Signing off for now.
I'm bored. I'm in the mood for something a bit more confrontational. Any ideas?
Reality TV could be good.
We're in for a real treat for the final round of Hell's Kitchen, introducing our taste testers, Aiden Campbell, Emma Berman, and last, but certainly not least, the beautiful Max Friedel. Your task will be to create a simple dish, a cupcake.
Ooh.
You will be judged on your creative aspect as well as its taste. I don't know what else to say, except for have fun, and I'll be making the rounds to see how everyone is doing. You have 30 minutes. Your time starts now.
I know Chef will be impressed with my cooking skills. I worked really hard for this. I hope he's aware of my studies at UMiami. My mom and I back in the day used to bake together.
We see here you haven't made much progress. What is going through your head?
Oh, I'm not worried one bit. The chef will love what I have in store for him.
Wow, Chef Dim, this is impressive. I must say, your progress is quite unbelievable.
Thank you, Chef.
Katie.
Yes, Chef?
I quite frankly don't understand why you're relaxing. Have you finished cooking?
Well, yes, actually.
Okay, let's see.
What do you think, Chef?
KB, did you honestly think that I wouldn't notice this cupcake is store-bought? I mean, come on, for bloody hell, you donkey! Get out of my kitchen, you damn wanker! Get out of my kitchen! All right, guys, time's up. Best of luck.
A solid effort. A little too salty, and the icing to cake ratio was just a little too strong. I'm sorry, but in fact, this sucks.
This isn't the traditional cupcake I've tasted in recent competitions, but I really enjoyed it.
David, just get out. Finally, Max, go ahead.
Oh yeah, this is fire. You're going in the finals.
Okay, I think we know who our final two are. Jenny and Elle, okay? Get ready to see who wins Hell's Kitchen. First off, Chef Dim, give me your cupcake.
Here you go, Chef.
Let's dig in. This is beautiful, Chef Dim. Just beautiful. Your work at UMiami has really paid off. Your mother would be so proud.
Thank you, Chef. It's an honor.
Here you go, Chef.
This is shocking. Shockingly awful in taste. In all my years, I've never tasted anything so bloody disgusting. Now get out of my kitchen, you donkey! Congratulations, Chef Dim. You've won Hell's Kitchen.
Thank you. I can't believe it. I can't wait to tell my mom this amazing news.
We actually have her here on set. Mom, come out.
Here, Mom, try my cupcake.
This is awful.
That had me at the edge of my seat. Let's see what we have next.
All right, where's Maddie?
Oh, there you are.
How many times did I tell you not to eat in here?
Anyways, I can't seem to find anything here on the 2010s.
I have an idea. Ever since I was a young girl, I've always been a big fan of Justin Bieber.
What?
I mean, yeah, maybe we can look at one of his music videos from the 2010s.
Sure.
First love. There was nobody that compared to my baby. Nobody came between us or could ever come above. She had me going crazy. Oh, I was starstruck. She woke me up daily. Don't need no Starbucks. She made my heart pound. Skip a beat when I see her in the street and at school on the playground. But I really wanna see her on the weekend. She knows she got me dazing, cause she was so amazing. And now my heart is breaking, but I just keep on saying,
baby, 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 oh.
So sorry, 11s, it took so...
Aiden, what are you doing in my seat?
What are you watching? Shouldn't you guys not be preparing for the test on the War of 1812?
Exactly! Sorry.
Anyways, I know this test is gonna be super important at the end of the year, so we need to pay attention.
Don't worry, Mr. Streeter. We know all our stuff already. We're prepared, trust me.
Oh, really? Carter, who organized the French-Canadian militia for the War of 1812?
Gordon Ramsay?